So today I'm going to show you a mix from beginning to end using only Slate plugins. This is an acoustic cover of an Incubus tune called Drive, recorded at Newcastle College for the local college label, performed by a guy called Jordan Kendall. He's given me the stems to allow me to do a mix and this video. It's been on my to-dos for a little while. As you can see, this has got four stereo tracks, which are acoustic guitar, and then it's got four mono tracks, which are vocals. I'm going to take you through my mix process from the beginning to the point where I'm happy to have my first proper listen. This is something I do quite regularly, whereby I will mix, do all my prep and a first initial mix where I'm ready to go and take it and listen to it on my phone through headphones or go and listen to it in the car or whatever. So I'm going to take you all the way up to that point. And then on Thursday this week, there should be another video coming out, which is from that point all the way to the end. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix this track only with Slate plugins. I really like their plugins. I use them a lot on nearly everything. So I'm going to take you through my process. So the first thing I want to do is I want to have a listen and I want to have a rough balance. I just love rough level balance just to see what's going on. So I'm just going to turn everything down. I'm going to have a listen. I've had a listen already, so I'm not going to make you listen to the whole track. But I'm going to listen from here where I can pick up at least most, or if not all, of these tracks, and then I'll have another listen here later on and we'll do a rough balance. Once I let the fear take the wheel and steer, it's driven me before and it seems to have a vague haunting mass appeal, but lately I'm beginning to find that I should be the one behind the wheel. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. Cool. I'm happy with that. I'm just going to have a listen to the bit where I think this must be a guitar solo.
Myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll...
Cool. So I've got a rough balance. Just it means that nothing's being too angry at me when I'm mixing. So the first job I want to do is I want to bring in my mix bus. This is something I do on every track, so I am listening with essentially like a pre-mastering chain, all ready to go. So open up my mix master template, and all I want to bring in is the print channel, which is that one. No effects yet, we'll do effects a bit later on. So the mix bus is in place and I want to show you what's in there. So I've got the Slate virtual mix rack, which is currently set to SSL desk with a little bit of drive on it, but there's nothing else. I may change this later on. I may change the desk to Neve. I think on acoustic tracks they tend to stick everything through Neve preamps, so I may change that in a bit, but we'll see. Then I've got the FG Grey, which is a SSL bus compressor, which is great. Then I have got a Pultec, but this has to come out because I'm using only Slate plugins today, so let's change this for another EQ. So I'm going to go for another mix rack. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick EQ in. Let's see what we've got. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick it in a new channel strip for the moment. but this may change. So at the moment it's set completely to flat, but it's doing the job of my valve EQ. Then I have my tape machine. So just to show you the whole thing, this just adds a little bit of saturation at the end. You don't get any additional noise. All you get is those the tape compression and the harmonics associated with that saturation. So all I want to do now is I want to route everything into that print channel, which is my master bus. So I'm going to add in my groups. The master bus is in place, so now I need to add my auxiliaries so I can create groups from the tracks, and those will be routed directly into the master bus, and these tracks will be routed into the auxiliaries. So let's create our auxiliaries. I think I'm going to go 6 because of what I'm thinking about, what I'm going to do with the effects and how I want the sends to work. I think it would make sense for me to have 6. So 6 stereo auxiliary tracks. I'll create those. I'm going to be cheeky and just colour them while they're there. So I want to turn that into the bus. Copy that just to make it easier. Double lead. Harmonies. Okay, so now I want to route these out to their specific tracks. So as you can see, what's happening is when I select the output of the track to a new track, it is automatically defining the input of the auxiliary, which is a neat little trick. It saves you doing lots of IO. So vocal main to vocal main. This is just how I tend to work. So this little bit of prep at the beginning, even though I've got lots more channels auxiliaries than most people will think that I need, I think I'm going to do something vocal funky with the backing vocals and the double guitar. Not hugely out of the way, but it means that I can do some clever stuff with effects later on rather than getting myself stuck. So vocal double into vocal double, and then I want these two. So select them together using shift and then holding shift and alt, select your output and it will change everything that you've selected. It's probably my favourite keyboard command shortcut. So just going to double check that that's working. I'll take this section here and then we'll just make sure that everything, all the auxiliaries are playing, and then it's all going to the master bus. And I find that when I drive myself, my light is found. Whatever. No, because I've been an idiot. And all of these are going to the main outputs. They are not being sent to print. Because I'm a dip dot. Right, so let's do that again. And I find that when I drive myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow. Right, so that's all routed fine. I'm happy with that. What is happening is the master bus is compressing a lot already. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just stick a few dB of output gain on there, but I'm going to drop the threshold. And I find that when I drive myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms. So the settings for this is I've got a fairly slow attack. I don't have it the slowest. I don't want that for this. The release is set to auto, which seems to be what most people do on their SSL bus compressors. And to be honest, I agree. The ratio for this, I will probably drop that to 2.5, 3. I may bring it back up later, depending on how everything's sounding, but I don't want lots of compression to start with because I want to really work on those tracks. And then my threshold will be set to taste, so I'm getting around 2 to 3 dB of compression, just as a general listen. And then I may adjust it later on. So on my to-do list, which I create before I do every mix, rough balance, groups. Now the next job is to check the phase. That is, I want to double check that everything sits sort of in time and that these takes all seem to be in place. So I'm just going to have a quick listen to track soloed. So I'll listen to the main acoustic and the double, then I'll listen to this bit of acoustic and the lead, and then I'll listen to those two together. So what I want to do is I want to just have a quick listen, just to make sure that everything's sort of in time. Zoom in.
It's driven me before, and it seems to have a vague, haunting mass appeal. But
yeah, I'm happy with that. That's all fine. Just double check these vocals. So I've got a command 8 in front of me, so when you see me muting stuff and my hand randomly pointing towards the back corner of my little screen, it's because I'm pressing buttons and moving faders.
I'm beginning to find that when I drive myself.
Cool. Happy with those.
Whatever tomorrow.
Just have a double check. And I've cut them.
Choose water over wine.
Great. Fine. As a rule, I'm happy that it's been well recorded.
Before, and it seems to have a vague.
That everything's in time and the stems I've been given are accurate. There is some slight deviation in some playing, but absolutely nothing to worry about. Now I'm going to check the polarity of the guitars against themselves and the vocals against themselves, just to see how everything goes. So I want to mute everything that's playing. Then and what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick in a one band EQ. And all of these. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to set it to high pass because that's the job I'm going to do later. So just put it right back. I'm down to zero. Then I want to pull this across all of my tracks. Oh, so I need to get another one because I've gone stereo to mono. Do that all the time, just don't think. And what I'm going to use this plugin for is my polarity change. So I want to listen to the instruments against each other to make sure that they are, that the polarity matches and that there's no frequency cancellation. So I've done videos on this before. And then once that's done, it's sort of job done really for this sort of initial start of the prep. And then we can start looking at the frequency content of the tracks themselves. So that's the track in its own. Let's put that together. So that track is in polarity, so we can leave that, and then we'll come to this one and double check it. Cool, so that polarity was flipped, and that could be anything to do with mic position or it's just the way that it's recorded, the diaphragm's gone in a slightly different direction. So, I'm going to leave that in place. Then, let's try and find the double. So, I want to listen to these. And I want to check the polarity. Ever so slightly more low end with it flipped, which is fine. So now I'm happy that they are all in polarity with each other, and I'm going to do the same thing for the vocals, but I'm going to check them against the guitar, and then I'll start layering everything up. So take this section.
Sometimes I feel the fear of uncertainty staying clear. Sometimes I feel the fear of uncertainty staying clear. Sometimes I feel the fear of.
Yep, so that has been inverted. Then what I want to do is I want to check these against each other.
Seems to have a vague.
One thing I didn't do is I didn't solo save the channels. So this means that when you solo any of your tracks, and I'm pointing at these ones here, so if I solo any of those, it means that it doesn't stop that solo passing through its signal chain to the main outputs. So you can see that my print, my master bus, has already been set to solo safe, and I've just done those to this. So that means now when I solo any of the individual tracks that I'm listening to, it means that they will pass all the way through to the outputs.
Seems to have a vague. Four, and it seems to have a vague. Four, and it seems to have a vague. Four, and it seems to have a vague.
Cool. So I think I have a suspicion that this one will need flipping as well.
Four, and it seems to have a vague. Four, and it seems to have a vague. Four, and it seems to have a vague.
So that is the polarity tested for all of them. Now my next job is to go through and high pass everything. So I've done a video on this before. What I want to do is I want to high pass the instruments to a point where I'm getting rid of the low end that is not audible, and that just means that when I'm pushing everything through effects, and it just makes the mix a bit nicer. And I've already got a feeling that this track could use a bass guitar, but what we're going to do is mix it as is for the moment, and then if I do want to, after my first listen, think that it needs a bass guitar and it's lacking that, we'll add that in. And this high passing exercise will mean that we've created some space for that and got rid of all those unwanted frequencies that exist. So let's have a look. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a section. This section will do, and then we're just going to have a listen, and then what we're going to do is play with the high pass filter to allow us to just get rid of those frequencies.
Take the wheel and steer, much I let the fear. Take the wheel and steer, much I let the fear. Take the wheel and steer, much I...
Fine, just going to do the same again. So the double, I imagine it'd be the same around 35 to 40 hertz. So all I'm doing is I'm moving that high pass filter to the point where I can hear it, and then I'm pulling it back, just ever so slightly. And that just allows me to make sure that I'm not getting rid of any of the content that we want to retain in the in this guitar, but I'm getting rid of all the crap we don't need. Around there. I might be a bit more aggressive with some of the lead instruments as a rule, but only ever varies slightly. What we want to try and avoid is getting too aggressive, because you take away a lot of the low end and the sort of the feeling within the track. Acoustic guitars are full range instruments, so you need to make sure that you are very specifically careful with your high passes. So then if we deal with the vocal, we'll do the same thing.
Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah.
do the same for the harmonies.
I'm beginning to find that when I drive my I'm beginning to find.
Right, and the other one. Gets where it was.
I'm beginning to find that when I drive my I'm beginning to find that when I drive.
Cool. So, I know I said I was using only Slate plugins, but every door has got a one band EQ in it. So, but I'm going to do all of my main heavy lifting with only Slate, so before you get angry in the comments. Right, now the high passing's done, I'm just going to have another balance and then start playing with some pans. So, what are we doing? Just unsolo that, mute that. Let's pick this section here, because it seems to be where all the action is.
It's driven me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately, I'm beginning to find that when I drive myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow.
Cool. So I'm happy with that. I'm going to start playing with some panning now. So I'm going to concentrate on just the guitars. Main guitars are going to be panned 20-ish%. The double guitars are going to be panned 50%. Then the both lead guitars are going to probably be panned somewhere in between those. It may be that the double guitars become a bit wider. The reason that I keep them in quite tight is that when I'm starting to put reverbs, I can make it sound really wide by not everything having everything hard panned except those reverbs. It just means that everything gets a bit more lush, which is nice. So I'm going to play that section now, and we're going to do the panning as discussed. But I want to show you a cool little trick with these faders. So if you click on the little fader next to the output name, you'll see that you've got link and you've got opposite. This means that when you pan, they pan the opposite sides and that they're linked together. So you can adjust one pan at a time. So I'm just going to quickly go through and just do those just so that they're done. And it just means that we've got a nice, easy panning job. So I'm going to stick the main one about 20.
It's driven me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately, I'm beginning to find that when I drive myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there, I'll be there.
So we're not that far away from what we got, or what we originally discussed. I quite like that. The leads are inside of the main guitar and the doubles, which is quite nice because it sits around the vocal. The vocal is bang down the middle. And already I can push the levels up on the guitars because I need to sort of fill that space. And because we've got that width now, it means that I can actually do some, I can get a bit more output, which is nice.
It's driven me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets. gets around. And lately I'm beginning to find that when I drive myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah.
Cool. So that's working quite well. I really want to start working on the vocals. So I want to get the vocals into a nice spot. So the vocal double, because everything's mono, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the harmonies. I think I'm going to put the harmonies in the same sort of space as the acoustic double. So if we just have a look what's going on. Yeah, so they sit. When the acoustic double comes in, there's no harmonies. So what I can do is I can swap, I can fill that space with those two elements independently. So I'm going to put those around 50-ish, and then what we're going to do is we're going to have a see how that sounds.
It's driven me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately, I'm beginning to find that when I drive myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes.
Cool. So I'm happy with the levels and the panning for that at the moment. I want to do quite a lot of work to the vocal, and I want to do some bits of stuff to the guitar. The guitars are probably not going to do too much too. I had a go at doing this mix a while ago, and I ended up doing so much guitars they didn't sound like guitars anymore. Got myself down a proper black hole at 3 o'clock in the morning. So I don't think we're that far away from the guitar sound. Once I've done the heavy lifting through those tracks with EQ, compression, and anything else that I want to add to them, the next job is to start looking at effects. It's another high passing and everything's done. I'm just going to have a quick check of the master bus, then we're going to start doing the heavy lifting with the channels.
Sometimes, and it seems to be the way.
Cool, so I'm happy with that for the moment. So my next job is to go through and start doing the heavy lifting. So what I want to do is I'm going to use the Slate mix rack for all of these because it's great. So my usual thing that I like to do with acoustics is I'm going to chuck that preamp on, that EQ, and then an LA-2A. I may have a look at using the 116s, but I think they might be a bit aggressive for an acoustic sound that's already quite brittle from how it's been produced. This is my usual starting point for acoustic guitars. Like I said, I would normally have a look at the 76, but I think it's sounding a bit too brittle. So I want to give it a bit of saturation, but what I want to do, saturation and some nice compression. So I want to see how it sounds on its own, and then I'm going to see how it sounds in the mix, and then we can start looking at this EQ. So before, when I did the high passing, I could have quite conceivably done it here, but because it's a nice clean little little plugin, and I was able to do the player at the same time. It's just my normal process. So I could have used the Slate Plugins all the way through. So let's have a listen to the main guitar.
I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever to...
We'll turn the compressor off for the moment and just have a look at the... See what things that we need to fix.
I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. What...
So all I had a look at there was I boosted one of the bell curves so I could actually find the frequencies that I was looking to remove. Not necessarily remove, but just ones that I wasn't quite that happy with that I could just duck a little bit. And then while I was doing that, I was also listening to frequencies that I wanted to boost a little bit. So to give this a bit more body, I boosted around 800. Around 900, just to give it a bit of a lift, and then I've given it a little bit of a reduction at 3.2. You'll see on the preamp that I've saturated it, so I've added some virtual drive. I've added another section of virtual drive off the bottom of the EQ, and I've just given it a little boost, so nearly 2 dB boost. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to run some compression. It may be that I end up running a serial compression, but we'll see. So I'm quite happy with that. It doesn't sound like there's loads on there, but what I want to have to do now is a listening context. That's normally a lot longer than I'd work in solo.
I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow.
Cool. So that's starting to sound okay, we'll get everything else done. I'm going to copy this strip down because I want the same starting point for the doubles.
Behind the wheel.
What? But I want to treat the EQ differently. So I want to get rid of that boost. So I'm just going to reset all of the pop by holding down the Alt or Option key. I turn the compression off. And let's have a quick listen.
Behind the wheel.
Cool, so I'm happy with that in terms of an EQ point of view. I've made it a little bit brighter. I've pushed 1.6 and I've pushed the high shelf. Probably drop that back just a smidge so it's not too brittle. But what I'm trying to do is create some variation in those two takes. So we've got the variation in terms of the playing, but what I want to do is create some tonal differences. And then I think we're going to come just compress this a little bit harder.
Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah.
Cool. That's sounding quite nice. That's a good starting
point. Behind the wheel. Whatever tomorrow.
It's starting to sound a little bit brittle. So what I want to do is I really want to work on that vocal. So I want to stick in another mix rack. Then I'm going to go for the Neve again because I like it. I do like the Neve a lot. Stick two of these in and then I'm going to stick an EQ in. So one of the reasons that I mainly stick to the Neve preamp and the Neve EQ, when I'm mixing stuff like this, is that I like the same consistent effect on whatever audio you're putting through it, and it just makes it sound a bit more cohesive. So we're going to have a look at the main vocal. I'm going to drive this, I'm going to boost the levels a little bit, and then we're going to have a look at, see if there's any EQ that we need to sort out and anywhere that we want to boost.
Behind the wheel. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there, I'll be there. So if I decide to wait for my chance to be one of the hive, will I choose water over wine and hold my own and drive? It's driven me before and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately I'm beginning to find that when I drive myself, my life.
Cool, so I'm sort of happy with that. A little boost around 4.5, and I've dropped the high end a little bit just because I didn't want it to sound brittle and raspy. So now we're going to have a look at the compression.
Behind the wheel. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be this self. How much I let the fear take the wheel and steer. It's driven me before and it seems to have a vague haunting mass appeal. But lately I'm beginning to find that I should be the one behind the wheel. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. I'll be. So if I decide to wait for my.
Just adding that compression has just made it a little bit richer, which is really nice. What I'm going to do is I'm going to stick another one double. Double, double. We'll do the same. Let's have a look at it together, just see what they sound like.
Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. With open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. I'll be there. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. With open arms and open eyes, yeah.
Cool. So I've done a similar thing. I've just adjusted the EQ on that just to separate them ever so slightly, because that'll allow me, when I'm pushing them into their own sort of reverbs and delays later, it will allow me to sort those out. So I'm happy with how that main section is sitting at the moment. I'm very much at the limitations of how it's been recorded. I feel that there's a lack of low end in the guitar. Even though it was recorded with stereo, I think it could have really done with a large diaphragm on the body. But I'm assuming that that's not in there. But we'll see. We'll see. Now I've done that work, I'm just going to recheck the bus compressor. And then we'll see what's going on.
Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. With open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. I'll be there. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. With open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. I'll be there. So if I decide to wait for my chance to be one of the hive, will I choose water over wine?
Cool. So all I've done there is I've adjusted some of the settings on the bus compressor. I've changed the threshold. I reduced the ratio down to 4:1 to 2:1. Or 3:1 to then 2:1, and then I've adjusted the mic again. I've gone into the Neve EQ and a little boost in the low end, and then ever so slight tame at the top end. So hopefully that'll just help everything sort of sit together. And then the last thing to check is the output. So I'm gonna unleak these.
Whatever tomorrow brings.
And then that's sort of the main section sort of taken care of for the moment. And then I'm going to start looking at the leads. And then I'm going to start looking at the harmonies. Once we've done that, we can move on to the effects.
With open arms and open eyes, yeah. What?
So all I've done is just tweak the compression. On the vocals, I noticed it was starting to go into the amber a little bit. I want to try and avoid that. I've also moved the processing from the main and the double onto the bus. Because I didn't put it there to start with, which was an error. And then I'm going to leave the main in the vocal double there because I can't move it across. So I'm going to do the vocal harmonies together and the vocal leads together. Sorry, the acoustic leads together, which I'm going to do now. And then we're going to get a bit funky with this, I think. So we're going to add an air. Leave preamp again. It's great. Then I'm going to try a distressor, you know. I do like a good old distressor. And then we'll stick on an overall EQ for both sections. I'm aware that we've got two different things coming in here, but it's always worth a go. So what we have is our preamp into our EQ, then into our compressor, and then we've got this air EQ filter, which just adds a top-end breathiness. Breathiness, the right word? Just a high-end lift, which is really nice. Can be quite nice on vocals. I find it a bit overpowering. But sometimes it can be quite nice. We'll probably stick in the harmonies. So let's have a listen to the lead parts. We're going to listen to this section here and then see how we're feeling.
It's tripping me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately I'm beginning to find that when I drive myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. It's tripping me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately find that when I drive myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. I'll be there. And would you? Tripping me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately I'm beginning to find that when I drive myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open.
Cool. So that's sitting quite nicely at the moment. One thing I do want to look at is the panning of the leads. I think that the second one is just sitting a little bit too close to the vocal. So we're going to pull that out, and then we're going to pull the other one out a little bit further.
It's tripping me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately I'm beginning to find that when I drive myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. I'll be there.
Cool. Okay, so that sounded nice, a lot wider, a lot further away from the vocal. The first part of that lead, which is the lower in pitch of those two sections, sounds great. I'm going to leave that where it is. I'm happy with those combined settings for both. I'll probably end up coming back to the distressor at another point. But for what we want now, it's great. Now we're going to do the same thing for the vocals. Stick in our Slate Digital mix rack. then, like we've done before, I think I'm gonna go 76. I might go blue stripe. Let's go blue stripe. Blue stripe. And then we're gonna add the air EQ again, just to push those vocals. But let's try this. I've never used it before, but we'll see. It's always good to try things. So let's have a look at the harmony section.
It's driven me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. I'll be there, I'll be there.
Don't know what happened there.
Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. With it's tripping me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately, I'll be beginning to find that when I drive myself, my light is found. What it's tripping me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately, I'll be beginning to find that when I drive myself, my light is found. What it's tripping me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone. It's tripping me before, and it seems to be the way.
Cool. So what I've done there is I like what the vintage compressor's doing. I've given it a bit of a lift in the top end, and I've low cut it even more. I've given it some drive. So preamps driven, the EQ section, a little bit of lift at the top, and I've done a bit more low cut. Then the compressor. I am not driving the input that hard. I've dropped the attack ever so slightly. I've got a ratio of 1:8. And then I've got a low lift, which I'm going to take out because it seems a bit pointless. I'll leave it in because it's sounding quite nice. And then an ever so slightly high lift. So I A-B'd the big and the punchy and the present and the silky just to see what's happening. And let's have another quick listen.
It's driven me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets. It's driven me before, and it seems to be the way.
Cool, so the low lift's doing nothing really.
It's driven me before, and it seems to be the way.
And that's because of where I've low cut, but the high lift, we just want just a touch. Seems to be like another saturation, valve saturation circuit. I don't know what's a replica of. But it looks quite nice. Big Bakelite knobs on it. Great. So in terms of our sort of heavy lifting, we're sort of done now, really. What I want to do now is I want to start looking at reverbs and delays for the effects. Because it feels like a performance, in terms of something that's super produced, I want to look at having different reverb spaces, which I can put different elements in and try and position everything sort of front to back. We've gone left to right, so now my job is to push things back, make the elements that I'm looking to be present and forward in the mix sit there by pushing some stuff maybe further back than I would normally, and then having a look at potentially a really lo-fi ambient delay on the vocal, on the main vocal or on the harmonies, just to give it a bit of tonal character. And that may be something that we just do in terms of saturation. It may be just saturation is all we need, but if we can put that saturation with a delay, it might help. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to create my effect buses. So we'll do reverb. Yeah, we'll do a reverb. Then we're going to do a hall verb, which is just a bigger space. So the room that they're in, then a bigger space. And then I want a bigger space again. So we're going to go something like a cathedral. Verb. And then, so that's taken those three reverbs. It may be that we use something that is not a space, like something that is more like a shimmer. And that could be quite nice. And I might stick the harmonies through those, something like that as well. We'll have it, just in case we need it. For that, I tend to go with the Native Instruments Rowam. And it's the airy section of that, which is fine. Then I want we're going to end up with five reverbs here. And then I want a small vocal plate. So, the way that I get my vocal plate to work is I have a compressor at the beginning where I can send the vocal as a side chain to the compressor to duck the reverb. So I'll just show you how I do that. I usually just use the standard compressor. If we use the main vocal as a key input. It's tripping me before. What I'm going to do is I'm going to send our main vocal to that. You can see that the vocal is going to that channel, but it's also going into the compressor. So if I put the compressor before the reverb, it will duck what is being sent to the reverb. So you get the blooms and the reverb trails, but you don't muddy up the vocal. It's quite a cool thing. It's tripping me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. Cool. An EQ on, and because I'm only allowed to use Slate plugins, apart from a few cheaty ones like those. That little simple compressor and the one EQ. I'm going to stick on an infinite EQ. And then after that, I am going to stick on Verbswood Classics. So this is my plate. I haven't tempo mapped this, so I'm going to sort of judge it by ear. Tempo mapping is something I'd normally do, but I don't think we need it. I think we should be okay. But what I am going to do is I am going to just count, get a general BPM. So it looks that this is at 100 BPM. So do 60 divided by 100, it gives you 0.6. Of course it does. So if I take that down, if I want my reverb to be a quarter notes, because this is in 4/4, I would need that to be at 0.6. Whereas if I want it to last a bar, it would be whatever that is multiplied, 2.4. So, but if I want it to run at crotchets or quavers or minims, so minim's 2, what I want to do is I want to change that to 1.2.
I choose water over wine and hold my own and drive. It's driven me before and it seems to be the way.
Right. So we know that our quarter notes are 0.6. So, 0.6, 600 milliseconds. So I want to take that down to 2. Come on, I want it on the nose, really. Right. So, that's fine. And then with the infinite EQ, I want to, come on, pickle, on a low cut, sorry, that clicking is my command 8, being an op-ed. Take that up to that, yeah, it seems too much for the moment. Oh, come on, play the game.
I choose water over wine and hold my own and drive. It's driven me before and it seems to be the way.
Well, that sounds awful, doesn't it? Let's have a look at the pre-delay. Come on. So you want the pre-delay no more than like 20 milliseconds, because anything beyond sort of 30 or 40 you start to hear as a repeat, it doesn't hear as reverb. So that should sound a lot better now.
I choose water over wine and hold my own and drive. It's driven me before and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately I'm beginning to find that when I drive myself, my light is found.
Fine, so we got the vocal plate sort of set up. What I want to do is play with
I
it.
Choose water over wine and hold my own and drive. It's driven me before and it seems to be the way.
Cool, so I'm happy with that. Those backing vocals need to come down now. Cool, so what I want to do now is, now I've gone through the process of showing my little vocal plate trick, I want to set up some room reverbs. So normally for this I use Deverb, which is just the standard plugin that comes with Pro Tools. It's really good. But what I'm going to do here is I'm going to use the Verb Suite Classics, and then we're going to have a play and see what we can find. So what I'm looking for is rooms, there we go. So with the room, I want to have that around eighth note, so I'm looking at about 300 millisecond delay. And then I really like the, so if we change that, let's have a look and just listen. What we're going to do is we're going to send everything. We're going to send all of these to the room with varying amounts, but for the moment I'm going to send everything. If I copy copying that. If you hold option down, it'll copy it across with the settings that you've got. So that means all my sends now sit up plus that. And let's have a listen.
I choose water over wine and hold my own and drive. It's driven me before and it seems to be the way.
So pre-delay, I'm going to set that around sort of 10. So you'd be looking at, well, let's sit at 12, because that sort of matches, that's divisible by the milliseconds that we've got.
I choose water over wine and hold my own and drive. It's driven me before and it seems to be the way. Everyone else gets around, and lately I'm beginning to find a way.
So that is distorting, and that is awful. It seems to be around the main vocal, so we're just going to pull those back. Having less reverb going from the vocals means that it'll sit further forward in the mix, which is nice. This is just to give it a sense of where things are positioned in the room, so I want the guitar just a little bit further back. Sort of going, even though Jordan played both parts together, it's really useful in terms of trying to separate those instruments and making it feel like the guitarist and the singer.
I choose water over wine and hold my own and drive.
Well, I don't like that. Let's have a look at a tight room and pull that back.
I choose water over wine and hold my own and drive. I choose water over wine and hold my own and drive.
That's more like it. So we're going to do exactly the same in terms of EQ. I'm happy with that.
I choose water over wine and hold my own and drive. It's driven me before and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately,
right, so I'm just going to listen to this a little bit louder.
I choose water over wine and hold my own and drive. It's driven me before and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately getting to find that when I drive myself, my light is found.
So that's already, with those two reverbs in there, making it sound almost together, sort of removing some of that harshness. So we're just going to cycle between having those reverbs on and not. And then we'll see the actual difference it's making.
Sometimes I feel the fear of uncertainty stinging clear. And I
Can't help but ask myself how much I let the fear take the wheel and steer.
Cool. So, I think we're starting to get in a good place. I want to do the same thing for the whole reverb. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy up the Verb Suite Classics, and then let's see if we can send something to all of these. Excellent. So we're going to go less. So we're going to look at minus 15 as a starting point. And that means that we're sending less to it, which means that I can have the fader higher, because the faders that I'm using and the faders in Pro Tools aren't linear. So it just means it gives me more control. Ooh. And that hall, we're going to go halls. We're looking for the same sort of length as the plate, so 1.2. And let's have, try Jazz Hall, let's see what that does. 1.2 and then pre-delay, bring that back just a smidge.
Sometimes I feel the fear of uncertainty staying clear, and I can't help but ask myself how much I let.
Well, I like those already. Let's see if we can have a listen to the whole reverb just on its own and see if there's anything that we want to pull away from that minus 15.
It's driven me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately, I'm beginning to find that when I drive myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings,
So what I've done there is I've just taken the acoustic guitar main and double out a bit because it was starting to muddy those and you're starting to lose the attack. So I've just pulled those out and it's just brightened those up a little bit, just brought them forward just such. So I like those. I don't think we need a cathedral reverb, but let's have a look at the Rowan. Do you want to try something with the vocal plate?
It's driven me before, and it seems to be the way that everyone else gets around. And lately...
Cool, so all I've done is I've stuck in a 2K mid hump, and that just pushes it through. I've not really used this EQ before. I quite like that all the sections are allowed overlap, but it can't ding, and you're not necessarily seeing the EQ thing that you're creating because it's just layers and layers and layers. Oh, there we go. So we've got the band and global. So ignore everything I've just said, there's a button that does it for you. But that's good. Learning, always learning. So with the hall, a little bit darker, I want to take a little bit more top end off. Let's have a listen.
It's driven me before, and it seems to be the way.
Cool. So the vocal, with everything in there, the vocal's starting to sound a bit brittle. So I want to have a look at the double level initially.
Myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow.
sending that to the plate as well.
Myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there with open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. I'll be there. Myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings.
Cool, that sounds better, doesn't it? So sent that to the reverb, pulled the main level back a bit, and because it was pushing it too far away, I took some of that send out. Now I'm going to look at the Rowan. I know this isn't Slate, but it's really good. It's really good. It used to be free. I'm not sure if it is anymore. Let's send. Let's do something cool. Let's send the vocal plate to it.
Myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings out.
Just need to create an in and out for it.
Myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. With open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there.
Right. Hear those tails? So good. Right, we've got a pre-delay, we've got a massive mix. Change the size a little bit, I don't want it so big. Right. Feedback. Pre-delay is... There. Cool. So let's have another listen.
Myself, my light is found. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. With open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. I'll be there. And would you choose water over wine? Although.
Cool. So it's nice and washy. And if we can set that back underneath, it'll just maybe take some of the brightness out of the vocal. And I think we're starting to get into a good space. So we've done, obviously we've got everything going to the hall a little bit. Then we've got everything going to the room. Then we've got the vocals going to that plate. Then I've got the harmonies going to the Rowan. But I probably should send those to the plate as well. So we're just going to deal the Rowan first. And I'm probably going to stick the acoustic leads in that as well. Because it's nice and washy. I'm sure something exists like that in Slate, but I know this and it works really well for me. And I know I said I'd do everything in Slate. Right, let's have a listen to those harmonies.
For it seems to have a vague.
Nice. And then we're going to send that to the plate as well, I think.
For it seems to have a vague.
Right, what I want to do with those harmonies is I want to take a bit of top end off because it's starting to get in the way a little bit.
For it.
Right. Let's have a listen with everything in.
It's driven me before, and it seems to have a vague, haunting mass appeal. But lately, I'm beginning to find that I should be the one behind the wheel. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there. With open arms and open eyes, yeah. Whatever tomorrow brings, I'll be there.
Yeah, it's getting there. I'm not, from what we had to where we are, I'm happy. The more I listen to it, the more I don't like how the guitars are recorded, but that's just me. So I'm going to check the mix bus.
It's driven me before, and it seems to have a bear.
Right, one thing that seems to be happening is I think that lead is a little bit too compressed.
It's driven me before.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to change that to a LA2A, I think. Because it's so nice.
It's driven me before. It's driven me before, and it seems to have a vague, haunting map. It's driven me before, and it seems to have a vague, haunting mass appeal. But lately, I'm beginning to find that I should be the one behind the... It's driven me before, and it seems to have a vague, haunting mass appeal. But lately, it's driven me before, and it seems to have a vague, haunting mass appeal. But lately,
cool. So, change that to 2A, it sounds great. So, you can see as we're sort of working through, we're making little tweaks to stuff that's starting to annoy us when we start to build the mix. But I think we're sort of at a point where I'm ready to take this for the first listen. There's a lot to do. Let's have one listen through and then we'll see how we feel about everything. And then I'm going to stick a meter on it, which unfortunately is not Slate, it's Waves. I want to have a look at certain things. This isn't going to get released, I don't think. Well, but this is just an exercise for me to mix something like this. Most of the singer-songwriter acoustic-y stuff that I mix is nowhere near as aggressive as this. So it's just a nice variation and challenge. Cool, so I think we're in the right ballpark. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If you've got to the end of this video, thank you very much. I don't think anybody will ever see this bit. Cool, lovely. See you later.